Hello, cuties, it's Courtney here, and today I'm gonna show you how to get this glam, kind of sparkly, glowy, pinky makeup look for Valentine's Day, and also this hairstyle. Don't worry, this isn't permanent, so you can do this just to have fun, a little bit of pink and loose curls, and it will wash out immediately with shampoo. I think you should leave a comment telling me what color you would dye your hair if you were to dye it any color. For me, of course, it would be pink. Make sure you guys give the video a thumbs up and subscribe, and let's get started. All right, cuties, I have been really focusing on my skincare lately. Let me know if you want a skincare routine, but I'm starting out with this Lancer Sensitive Skin Moisturizer. This is just a lotion so that my skin is nice and hydrated. Then I'm going in with a Laura Mercier primer, and this is the moisturizing primer. My skin is just super dry, so this is amazing for me to have moisture underneath all of that makeup just to kind of protect my skin. Then I like to spray on my Prep and Prime Fix Plus from MAC, mostly because it just smells amazing. This is my favorite foundation for more glam looks. This is a really matte full coverage foundation. It's called Born This Way from Too Faced. It's amazing and it doesn't feel too cakey or too dry or anything. I just really like the formula and the finish that it gives me. Gotta do a little dancing. You guys know how it goes. Next, it's time for brows, and I've been using this Anastasia Brow Wiz pencil for a while now. For a little bit, I was trying the ColourPop Brow Boss pencil, which I really liked, and it was only like a quarter of the price of the Anastasia one, but I usually just switch off between those two. So I'm just kind of filling in my brows and making this shape a little bit more defined and clean, and then just combing through with the brush end. Now for eyeshadow, I'm using this beautiful ColourPop palette called Femme Rosa. It just has the most beautiful Valentine-y shades. It has just really pretty kind of pinky, maroon, magenta, bronzy, rose gold shades that I thought were just perfect for Valentine's Day. So first I'm going in with this shade all over my lids and just kind of creating a base so that we have some color all over, and then we can go in and start to define afterwards. So I'm just using a huge fluffy brush and being sure to blend this in everywhere. And it's okay if it's not perfect, because this is just kind of the first color that we're adding to our canvas. It's like a painting. Next, I'm going in with a little bit darker of this red shade and putting that into my crease. So I'm using a little bit smaller of a blending brush and just doing these back and forth motions, and then also some circular blending motions, and just being sure to keep that color in my crease for some more definition. The name of the game is blending, guys. Blending is so important, and it just takes your eyeshadow look to the next level. And this is the face you make when you get the notification that something you ordered online just got shipped in the mail. That's always exciting. Next up, you want to take a flat shader brush, and you're going to spray it with your setting spray. So I sprayed it with Fix Plus, and then I'm adding this shiny metallic shade onto my lids. And the Fix Plus just makes it more intense and shiny and beautifully sparkly, and just kind of turns it more into a paste instead of just a shimmer. It just makes it a little bit more dramatic. So just add that all over your lids, and if you need to add more Fix Plus in between, then go for it and just kind of pack that on. And next, we're going to do the same thing with Fix Plus, but we're going to add this really pretty golden shade just to the center of the lids. So I've actually never done this before, but I've watched a lot of YouTube tutorials, and I've always wanted to try this halo eye effect. So today is the day, and I love how it turned out. I think it just made my eyes really pop. Then I just added this really light shimmery shade that's kind of a pearl tone to my brow bone and my inner corner, just to make sure that we have some highlight and that the brow bone is popping. Next, it's time for eyeliner, and I'm using a really small angled brush for the application of these wings. And I've been using this liner for a while. It's the gel liner from MAC, and I really like it. I'm actually running out, so I need to get more. That's how good it is, guys. So I just applied these wings, and then now you want to curl your lashes and get ready for some mascara. I'm using the Marc Jacobs Major Volume Mascara, which is always my go-to, but I'm actually really looking into trying a new mascara soon. So can you guys leave any recommendations? Comment your favorite mascara below because I would love to try out your favorites. Now for lashes, I'm using these Ardell Faux Mink Wispies. I've actually never seen these, but I went to the drugstore and saw that they have this new faux mink collection and it looked luxurious, so I thought I would try it. And I just wanted the look to be glam. And next for concealer, I'm using my Too Faced Born This Way concealer. I think it just goes on really well, especially when you pair it with the Too Faced Born This Way foundation. So I just applied that onto any red areas on my face and then under my eyes, my forehead, and my nose. And then I'm just blending that in by dabbing with my beauty blender. Now we need to set it all down, so I'm using my Laura Mercier translucent powder and just kind of setting my under eye and then also just applying this all over my face, just a light layer so that we can kind of get everything set down and nothing is too sticky or cakey or anything. Everything is set for the day. It also feels really good. This powder just feels like a pillow. Now for bronzer, I'm using Afternoon Delight from ColourPop. I really have been wanting to try a new bronzer lately because I always use the same one. It's a really nice shade, and I'm also using this bronzer brush from ColourPop, which I really like. I think it just gives you some warmth and color in a very defined way. And then my last step during bronzer is just to apply it all over my nose and cheeks, just whatever's remaining on the brush, so that I get that all over color and it's not just on the sides of my face. Next, I'm using this blush by MAC, and I forget the name of this shade, so I'll put it in the description. I'm gonna link all these makeup products below if you guys want to check any out. Just adding that to my cheeks, and then it's time for highlighter, and this is my number one life hack, guys. Lately, I've been trying this and I love it so much. Just use the bottom of your beauty blender while it's still damp. Just kind of dab your highlighter in to your face and it looks so beautifully glowy and natural, and you really don't see any of the powder. It just looks like kind of a glow from within. And it's also very buildable, so you can make it very metallic or very soft. Also, this highlighter is called Wisp and it's from ColourPop, and I 100% recommend it. I think it's only like $6, and it's one of my favorite highlighters I've ever used. And now for lipstick, I really want the shade of the lipstick color to be really true to how it looks in the container. So I'm first kind of dabbing in this concealer onto my lips so that I have a nice base and so the color will be more vibrant. And then I'm applying my lipstick. This is Kylie Cosmetics in the shade Smile. It's just a really pretty pink, and I also love that the proceeds from this lipstick were donated to Smile Train to help children with cleft lip surgeries so that they can smile. I just love that so much. So I thought this was the perfect shade to kind of complete this rose gold look. Now we gotta do hair. I wanted to keep the actual hairstyle simple since we're gonna play with color. As you guys saw on the thumbnail, my hair is about to be pink. So I'm just kind of using this top section of hair and putting that in a ponytail so that I have kind of half of my hair up and half down. So we have a little bit of height and volume, and it's just kind of flirty and fun. And now I'm adding some soft curls with this Conair curling wand. I usually take sections that are about an inch or two wide, and I just make sure that they turn out to be a ringlet, and then I just kind of let it sit and cool off. Once all my hair is curled, then I can kind of brush through all of my curls with my fingers, and it kind of loosens up and gets more, you know, romantic and laid back. So now that we have the curls, it's time to add that color. So I just picked this up at the drugstore. It's the L'Oreal Colorista Hair Spray, and it washes out with shampoo. You gotta get your towel on, guys. Looking cute in my towel. And then it's time to spray on. You can just add it to whatever pieces you like. I definitely sprayed my hands and my face during this process. So that is the final look. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I hope that you have an amazing Valentine's Day. Just remember that you are beautiful, you are unique, and you are special, and you have a unique purpose in your life. And I hope that you guys know that all you need is yourself and God. He's got your back. I really do feel like a mermaid. Should I dye my hair? Thank you, babes, so much for watching this video. Definitely let me know what kind of videos you want to see in the comments. I hope you have a beautiful Valentine's Day. I love you so much, and I will see you in my next video.